this is the very first live-action film from Travis Knight, founder and frequent director of Laika Movies. He's also the son of Phil Knight, who has Nike and all that Nike money, and that's how Travis Knight came to be able to do Laika, right? To be able to start with his own company. He's kind of like the Megan Ellison of animation, with a similar spotty track record. You know, getting a lot of praise, but just can't break through. Can't have that big winner, either at the box office or even with awards. But it's interesting because another animation, founder of a studio and director, Chris Wedge, he went on to do Monster Trucks as his live-action hopeful breakout movie, and it didn't turn out. But they're actually very similar properties when you come to think of it. And also, they were both for Paramount. So I think it's interesting that Paramount, after Monster Trucks, was like, let's try and do that again. Although, they seem to have run out of options, or at least a multitude of options with their Transformers franchise. How many people want to be associated with this thing at this point? And so you get Travis Knight trying to do a Hail Mary and move into live action and take this opportunity. And you have Hailee Steinfeld, whose career has floundered, and John Cena, who maybe is on his way up. I think Bumblebee could help decide that. So let's take a look at it. I'm hearing Iron Giant comparisons, and I think that's fine as long as it's inspired by the Iron Giant and isn't an Iron Giant ripoff. All right, let's take a look. This place is the 70s, by the way, I think. Or like, not the 60s. All female-led pictures have to take place at a different time period for some reason. Women like time travel? I don't know where that comes from. Oh, she's gonna get a new set of wheels.
A driver don't pick the car. Car pick the driver. It's a mystical bond between man and machine. It's a mystical bond between man and machine.
Down all the moving parts. I think that's a good idea. Oh, it's old school Bumblebee with the nipples. I don't know if I would have done that. It's like the bat suit.
Who are you? Do you speak? I won't hurt you.
That's adorable. Why is this a Christmas release? It's clearly a summer movie, like Aquaman. Although Jumanji did very well. That was some bad CGI right there. Don't be mean, John Cena. Oh, cool. I like the low-key transformation.
You got people out there who need you. This is why you're here, B.
Oh, that is a very manga-friendly look there on Bumblebee.
Music can help you say what you're feeling. Try this.
That is a good song, Bumblebee. I liked Hailee Steinfeld's hair, but I think that this Bumblebee movie's just wearing her. You know, I think she doesn't seem, I don't know. I think Bumblebee's look, it's fascinating to me. I like to think about how brands restructure themselves or transform for modern audiences. And this reminds me of like the Thundercats debate. Also, this looks just like the alien design that seems to be debuting later today with the Lego Movie 2. But it reminds me of the new Thundercats and, you know, taking old school properties and revamping them for what current tastes are. And I wonder how hardcore Transformers fans are going to feel about this very different look for Bumblebee. I mean, he still has the classic look, but this could be, I mean, I'm curious. Does anyone like, I wasn't into Transformers before, but maybe now I am. I mean, that's, I guess that's the big question. Like, is this enough to bring anybody back? I don't know. I still think it has the Michael Bay look with of like a lot of sun flare, right? You know, I think Hailee Steinfeld even looks a little like Mark Wahlberg a little bit. She could easily pass for his daughter. So it doesn't seem like enough of a departure. Like I was saying you shouldn't fully rip off the Iron Giant, but you could have got a little closer to that territory maybe, right? And even though this is a period piece, it's very, very vaguely a period piece. So I don't see a lot of success here, particularly in an extremely crowded holiday marketplace this year. But I'm curious to what you think. And also, I think as for Travis Knight, I'm surprised he didn't seem to bring more to this. You know, you would have, maybe he was behind this idea for the redesign, and I did like having less moving parts with the Transformers because, you know, before you were like, I don't know what I'm looking at. But here, it's missing the Laika magic and heart, at least in this trailer. And I would be like, well, what'd I hire you for, Travis, if you're not going to bring those properties with you? He's like, I don't know either. I'm scared. I'm going back to stop motion. And he is, actually. All right. What do you guys think? Write your thoughts down below. Thank you for watching with me, as always. And, of course, you can check out some more videos right now.